bad.
Oh, sorry. Sorry.
I told you this day was cursed.
Sorry.
Oh. All right.
Good luck, baby.
Here you go.
Wait, Anthony. Please don't do it today. You're gonna fail.
Alexander, give your brother some space, please.
Yeah, the next time you see this face, it's gonna be my driver's license.
It's not coming off.
Just hurry up. I need to get to my play.
What kind of a person?
It's not poisonous.
Obviously, one of the things that has to work if this movie's gonna work is you guys have to feel like a family.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
So what did Miguel do to kind of help you guys with that, or what did you do with each other that kind of helped you bond?
We just spent a lot of time together. We did a lot of rehearsals, and we just hung out together.
Yeah.
Just heaps. We were there every day. We'd just, you know, wake up, see Kerris and Dylan, go to bed seeing Kerris and Dylan and stuff.
Dreaming about us, actually.
Dreaming about them.
Dreams about each other.
Dreams,
all the time.
Yeah, I think it started with Miguel. Like you said, it started with him sort of assembling this cast of a family. Because if the family was off, if the dynamic was off, I think the movie could have been very different.
Yeah.
So I think it started with him and then continuing to be the sort of driving force to the family.
It's interesting because I'm raising two boys.
Yes.
So the big brother, little brother dynamic is always fascinating to me. And,
yeah.
And there's some give and take between you guys. There's some affection and there's also some,
brotherly
like ribbing.
Like a regular sibling rivalry, definitely.
Did any of that play out on the set as well? Did you guys play around on the set? Was there any...
I think Ed pranked me more. And
I love pranking people. I love scaring people.
You reverse the sibling dynamic. Usually it's the older brother.
Yeah, I was bullying him. I was like, come on, Dylan. Why are you hitting
wake
yourself?
Wake up, Dylan.
Dylan, God, come on.
On our character side, one of my favorite parts of the movie... Well, it feels weird because it involves me, but is when
conceited.
I know it's when Anthony at the end says to Alexander, and he hits him, and Alexander goes, "What was that for?" He goes, "I forgot to wish you happy birthday today."
That is just having an older brother, you know, with similar age gap. That is exactly what would happen.
It's very poignant, actually. It's a really good moment.
Yeah,
good job, guys.
I would think for any performer, one of the real nightmares is kind of what happens to you, which is you're under the weather, you have to perform. And perhaps you don't handle it with the greatest poise.
No, that's putting it very nicely. Thank you. I appreciate that.
So have there ever been any moments for you guys as performers where you haven't felt up to snuff, but you've had to push on? And if so, how? How did you guys do it?
Yeah, I mean, it's something that comes along and just being a performer and anytime. I know I got back from a music festival and I had screamed for so long, for like 3 days straight. Screaming, 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 and then they text, like, I got an email that said, okay, you're working on Monday, the Monday following, and I was like, awesome! So I went
you're
in the next
like,
day, and I was like,
awesome!
Hey, guys! And I had this big, like, party scene that I had to do, and walking around, and it was pretty crazy. I felt a little bit like Emily in that regard, but, yeah, I think that happens to anybody. You
always have those moments when you just go, wow, I regret doing that.
Yeah.
Why today?
Why today? Yeah. That's a major theme in my life sometimes.
Why today? And then finally, Alexander really is the glue that holds this movie together.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a lot of screen time for you in this film.
A lot.
How comfortable were you at the beginning of this? And over the course of the film, did you ease into it? Was it something that you felt comfortable with on day one?
Yeah. Oh, no. I think on day one, on every shoot, there's always a little bit of... kind of protection against yourself when you're a bit nervous because, A, that's the first time. Yeah, first day of school. It's often you know the cast and the director, but you don't know any of the crew, which is more people than the cast and the director. So there's all these people watching you and it's very nervous. But then I like to meet everyone, have my little jokes with everyone, so then I feel really comfortable. So I ease into it. And by the end, I felt like I was hanging out with my best friends, and I forgot that there was a crew there. I forgot that there was a camera there because I was hanging out with these guys. And,
we all got to, his nickname on set was Crispy Bacon. So we all, by the end, were calling him Crispy Bacon, and you would answer to it.
We
and
had
everything.
T-shirts.
Yeah, we had T-shirts. It said sign language, so it had CB.
The costumes, the T-shirts.
He was CB. Ed on the call sheet. Ed, CB, Oxenbould.
Yeah.
For the latest from HitFix, visit HitFix.com or download the new HitFix app on your Roku device.